There's commotion in my brain, strange is the notion. Words cannot explain my range of emotion. I'm speechless, my flaws exposed and my weakness. Each breath draws me closer to a deep test. It's month number 7, it's been 10 days. I've been awake all night, reflecting on my ways. A threat to my peace in this greatest of moments. Cause I'm the high priest and it's the day of atonement. The Lord is so holy and perfect, I'm nervous. I'm floored that he chose me to worship through service. Don't ask me why the God who crafted these skies drafted this weak guy from the clan of Levi. Preceding generation taught me to read the regulations. Deep meditation on decreed revelation. Extreme trepidation breeds hesitation. Yet I must lead and be the representation. My occupation to intercede for the nation. But indeed my own sins need expiation. The wrath of Jehovah's grim, sin is no joke to him. The hope is slim for unholy men coming close to him. He's spoken in his word the proper way of approach to him. Nadab and Abihu got it wrong and he roasted them. These things I weigh as I sigh. This could either be the greatest day of my life or the day that I die.
So you say that you wanna know the Lord. Do you really wanna stand before the Lord? Do you know what it takes to meet the Lord?
God is an all-consuming fire.
So you say that you wanna know the Lord. Do you really wanna stand before the Lord? Do you know what it takes to meet the Lord?
Be careful what you desire.
For now, no time to focus on my sinning. I bathe in the laver, though it seems extreme. I put on the holy coat made of white linen, craving his favor. I'm ceremonially clean. I check to inspect, no tangible faltering. Next, I must collect the animals for the offering. A spotless ram and a bull, the components God gives to make atonement for my own sins. This part of the ritual makes me real cautious, because the very sight of blood makes me feel nauseous. Still I proceed by snatching him close, slashing his throat when his blood splashed on my coat. Reacting, I choke, gasping, that's when I'm grasping God's reaction. That sin provokes. I take a moment to reflect on the blood spilt in this. Staring at the goat to be sent into the wilderness. I'll confess Israel's sins with my hands on his head, symbolizing guilt transferred instead to a substitute. The living God provided and stamped guilty of our sin driven outside the camp. This beautiful picture of hope and grace motivates, and I don't want my fear to make this dope occasion go to waste. Change my outer garments, slow my pace. Yo, I brace myself to stand before Jehovah's face in the holy place.
So you say that you wanna know the Lord. Do you really wanna stand before the Lord? Do you know what it takes to meet the Lord?
God is an all-consuming fire.
So you say that you wanna know the Lord. Do you really wanna stand before the Lord? Do you know what it takes to meet the Lord?
Be careful what you desire.
The time has come, the great moment has arrived. About to enter in, what a lonely enterprise. Look at the other priests, they speak only with the eyes. Rope tied around my ankle just in case I don't survive. I enter through the first curtain to a dark room. I'm standing in the holy place, my thoughts consumed. I'm caught off guard, I'm unraveling at this stage. My heart beats so hard, it's rattling my ribcage. Feeling like I'm disintegrating and I can't stand. Comforted by the light emanating from the lampstand. This helps my vision, I can see the showbread. I think of God's provision that helps me go ahead. I need courage to worship, man, this is intense. I take burning coals off the altar for the incense. The sweet aroma fills the room. The smoke protects my eyes, one sight of Jehovah seals my doom. It's no mere coincidence, I'm here surrendering. With fear and trembling, I'm nearly entering. I feel like running scared, hoping I'm not unprepared. Stunned with fear, no one comes in here but once a year. Nevertheless, I'm at the point of no return. Besides, I don't want my anointing to be spurned. After counting the three, next time I exhale, I'm in the holy of holies beyond the veil. The first thing I realize is I'm thrilled that I've entered into God's presence and yet I'm still alive. I'm awestruck by the weight of his terrible beauty. It's almost unbearable, but I must fulfill my duty. Approach the ark, the first part of my work's complete. When I sprinkle blood 7 times on the mercy seat, quickly I exit, impressed with the hesed that rescues the wretched and left us accepted.